Hey everyone, welcome back to another Figma tutorial. In the last video, we learned how to create reusable style. We can easily change colors, text and effect styles, but many times that's not enough. Imagine if you need to make changes like moving avatar images from left to right or changing them from circle to a square. You'll still have to do it manually. In this video, I'll share everything you need to know about reusable components. You can make such changes in few clicks across your designs. Timestamps are added in the description so that you can easily skip or repeat specific topic. Let's get started. Let's start with the basics. Components are design elements that can be reused across your design files. You can combine all the techniques we have learned so far, like frames, constraints, auto layouts, and styles in the components. Together, they make our designs more consistent and offer a lot of flexibility. You can create component of any layer, group, or frame. Just select it and right-click to create a component. You can also use keyboard shortcut or click on the components icon in the top toolbar. Once it's created, it is called as main component. Earlier, it was called as master component. You can identify main component in the layers panel by this four diamond icon. You can create multiple components at once with one neat feature. This is a huge time saver if you want to convert a lot of design elements into components. Take these icons for example. First, select all the icons. Go to top toolbar and click on the little drop down in front of components icon. Click on create multiple components and boom! All icons are now converted into individual components. You can reuse this main component by duplicating it using keyboard shortcut or dragging while holding an option key. This component is an instance of main component. You can identify it in the layers panel by hollow diamond icon. If you resize this button, alignment seems off, but we can easily fix that by changing the main component. Whenever you make any change to main component like changing style or constraints, it is transferred to an instance. You can override some properties in instance, like text, fill, and other styles. By default, it does not affect the main component or any other instances. Sometimes, you might want to get rid of all the overrides in the instances. You can easily do that by going to Right Panel, Instances section, and click on Reset Instance icon. Here you can reset all the overrides or a specific override like a fill color. In some cases, you might want to transfer overrides to your main component. You can do that by using Push Overrides option. If you want to unlink instance from main component, you can right click on it and select Detach Instance. If you want to delete main component, there is no direct way. First, create instance and delete the main component. In the end, detach the instance. If you accidentally delete main component, you can quickly fix it. Right click on instance, go to main components, restore main component and it will be restored. We can organize components using pages, frames and slash naming convention. This will make them easy to find. It's always best to place similar components inside a frame. You can group them further by adding group name followed by slash and component name. To do that, we have bulk rename option in Figma. This is extremely easy to use. Choose all the icons you want to group, go to layers panel, right click, click on rename. In this pop-up window, you can type your group name and slash and then select current name option, which will retain all the current icon names. Click rename and done. All of the selected icon components will be renamed. You can now see these groups in Assets panel as Pages, Frames, and Groups. It is also visible in the right side panel where you have your instances. Organizing components makes it extremely easy to find components, instances, and make them easy to swap. Just like frames, we can nest components. In simple words, you can add component within a component. An important thing here to note is we cannot nest two main components together, but we can nest an instance. Even if you accidentally select the main component, Figma takes it out and replaces it with the instance. Nesting components takes reusability to the next level. Let's take a simple example. Create different types of button components, primary, secondary, and tertiary. You can create their instances and reuse them easily. Now imagine a scenario where you want to tweak a button radius from rounded to flat. With current setup, you will have to modify all three main button components. Here's a smarter way to do it. Create the main button component, create an instance and add it inside another component. As it is an instance of main component, it will inherit all properties of that. Now override some values and make it secondary button. Repeat the same procedure and create tertiary button. Just like an earlier case, you can create instances and reuse them. Now here comes the best part. All these buttons are instances of the main button component. Changing stuff like border radius becomes extremely easy. Just change it in the main component and done. All the instances will be updated at once. Let's try a little advanced version, creating a flexible input field. Start with the basic structure, a label, input field, input text, secondary text. Alternatively, you can also attach an instance of an icon and cursor to make it complete. Select everything and create a component. Now create different states of input fields like active, inactive, field, error, and success. Start with an instance and nest it inside a component. Now make overrides to fill and stroke effects. Once created, you can control all the states with main structure component as all the states are nested components. Let's put everything in action. We can easily reuse components by swapping. To illustrate this feature, we can create simple corporate signup form with different fields. You can start by adding instance of an input field. Duplicate it multiple times to create employee ID, email, password, date of joining, and designation fields. You can overwrite text to change labels. The next thing we need is relevant icons for different fields. This is where instance swapping comes into an action. Select icon component that you want to swap. Open Assets panel and find your icon. Drag that icon into selected instance while holding Option and Command keys. Figma will instantly swap both instances. Not just icon, but you can also swap components too. Try swapping employee ID to success state, email with field state, and password to error state. To modify this input style, you just need to update main component and all instances will be updated in no time. Figma also retains all the overrides. I hope now you can create and use reusable components in Figma and save countless hours in your projects. That's it for today. In the next video, I'll cover prototyping and sharing options. Hit like if this video was helpful and consider subscribing to this channel to stay notified about the next tutorials on Figma. If you want to suggest a new topic or have feedback for me, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you in the next one.